हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज़ शिवम जाजरिया एंड आई एम योर मैथ्स टीचर। लास्टली वी हैव स्टार्ट आवर एक्सरसाइज 1.1 एंड आई होप यू हैव प्रैक्टिसिंग सम क्वेश्चंस बाय यूजिंग दिस वीडियो विच इज पार्ट 1 एंड पार्ट 2। दैट पार्ट विल बी द पार्ट 3 इन योर video series. In the part 3 you are solving exercise 1.2 and by following some questions I am discussing some question here and you are solve by your practice. In this exercise you are just needing multiplication perfection. What is multiplication perfection? You are just understand all the multiplies by yourself. And I hope you are know all the multiplies by table or by following your methods. First question is that fill in the blanks. And what we are doing in this part, minus 12 multiply with the minus 2. First we are saying that what is the sign of both the terms. Minus minus, it's plus. So plus sign is coming, which we are not writing in our symbol integers when plus sign is coming. Okay, so plus and 12 to j, it's 24. Now next thing is that you are solving that type of questions, but you are multiplying with the zero. What the result? The result will be zero. And when we are multiplying the same first you have one, then answer will become the same value. When we are multiplying with the m cross n, the answer will become n cross m. Okay, when we are applying the distributive property which you are reading in the last classes, so a distributing the both terms, a first multiply with p, we writing here a multiply with the q, we write here. Okay, now in the next question number 3, multiply both the terms minus 18 and minus 21. So answer will become by multiplying both the terms which you are multiplying in the your way, 18 and 21, multiply both the terms, it's 8 1 to 8 16. To multiply with the 8, the answer will become 16. 1 carry is here, 2 1 is 2 and 1 3, so the answer will become 378. Minus and minus, it's plus, so 378 is the answer. You solve all the questions by this following method. You are already known what is the multiply of the two terms, so solve by yourself. I am explaining this type questions. Simplify. When you are seeing the that type of terms, evaluate, solve, simplify, simplify and reduce, calculate. So solve, so all the terms means solve the question. Okay, all the same sign and all the needs of question solving is given in the equation. Just solve that. First we are seeing that question, so 13 will be common from that question. So 13 is here, minus 8 is here and minus 11 is here. We have solved that 13 is here, minus 8 is here and plus minus is minus, so minus 11 is here. 13 multiply with minus and minus plus, so 8 and 11 is 19, so minus sign is coming. Minus 247 will be the answer by multiplying both the terms. Okay, so solve this question, this type of question, by taking common method or distributive property. Okay, this type of property we are applying in that question. Okay, now in that question 23 is already given in the common section, and minus 4 and minus 2, so plus minus is minus, so minus 4 minus 2, and minus minus is plus, but sign is sign taking, we taking the sign minus. 4 and 2 is 6. 23 multiply with the 6, 138 will be the answer, minus by minus sign. Okay, solve this type of question by the last questions, by following last questions. Now next question is that question number 5, use a suitable property of integer to evaluate the following state, the property used. By suitable property, which one the property associative property, commutative property, you are just reading in the first part, no? So you are understanding that type of questions by using the suitable property. When you are taking any step, you are solve this question by properly. Okay, first you see 23 is common in the both the section, so taking common 23 from that type of question. Minus 9 is writing in the bracket, and minus 7 is also writing. Plus minus 2 sign is again coming, so minus 7 is the separate in the bracket. Plus minus is minus, minus 9 and minus 7, so answer will become minus 16, but after multiplying final answer will become 23 multiply with the 16, 368, by using some multiplication you are solved that type of question. Minus 368 will be the final answer. Solve this type of questions by following all the terms. That type of questions. This is the simplest question. Minus 15 multiply with the minus 15, 1 upon minus 15. So 15, 1 is 15. So it's coming the 1, and minus sign will also be cancel. So answer will become 1. Okay. What is the multiplicative inverse? Multiplicative inverse is just multiplying that term, the answer will become 1. So when we are seeing that minus 32 multiplying with the x, x will be the multiplicative inverse, the answer will become 1. So x is writing here, and minus 32 is going in the downside, so the answer will become 1 upon 32. And the answer will be the negative, so negative. So that is the multiplicative inverse. You are solve all the multiplicative inverse by following that step. Okay. So when we are going in the next question. Okay. Now question number 7 is starting. This is the mode terms. You are already see that the in the last exercise that type of question is coming, but in that question you have solve the equations in the mode, and first to solve the equation and after opening the mode you will become the final answer. Okay, so first we have take minus 6 into 2, so that will become some minus 12, and in the mode, after removing the mode, the sign will become positive, so the 12 is coming, and minus 6 into 2, so the answer is minus 12. But when we are comparing both the term, plus 12 is greater, so that term will be greater from that term. that type of answer you're writing here. Okay, all the question like that. When we are saying that question, because two mod is here, that term is also in mod, that term is also in mod. -9, -2, solve that. -9 and -2, you are saying that -11 will become the mod, so minus will be removed by the mod, so 11 is become. 9 minus 2 is 7, 7 is positive term, so no change is here. 11 is greater from 7, so that term will be greater from that term. Okay, like that you solve all the questions. Now in the last question, you are saying that you are giving some values A, B, C, like that of terms. First question is that A multiply with B and B multiply with A. You take LHS and RHS, put the all values A 15, B -3, and solve the terms -45. In RHS, you are put -3 from B and 15 from A. You solve that -45. So same values in LHS and RHS. So what is the question? You are proving equal both the terms. So both the term is equal, LHS is equal to RHS, hence proof. Like that you are solve all the questions of that equation. Okay, you are seeing, we are following, you are not what we are giving in the school, and solve all the question by your practicing. Do your work properly, and whenever you have some doubts, then discuss me on the comment section. First see video part properly, and after that you see again and again. When you are not understand, then that type of problem you are discussing in the comment section. Okay, thank you, have a nice day.